R. Kelly made a mistake, people. A mistake that could have happened to any of us, and yes, allegedly. I'm talking about the first time out, when I first saw the first video. When I saw that video, I said, this is just a mistake. No, because you can't tell how old these little girls are anymore. I can prove it was a mistake. Who saw the video? Who saw that first R. Kelly video? You saw that? You saw that? You saw that, sir, with the glasses? What's your name? Spencer, the police gonna want to talk to you. That's child pornography, goddamn it! All right, Spencer, since you saw that video, I want you to help me prove to these people that anybody could get in that trouble about getting with these girls who are younger than they look like. You saw the video. Remember the part where the girl was doing the sexual stuff, you know, sucking. She ain't look like no teenager then, did she? 24, maybe 25. But remember the part where she's standing near the bathtub and she, yes, I saw it, but it was research. The part where she was near the bathtub doing that shit, how old she looked then? 13, maybe 14. Here it is, people, here it is. It's the shit they put in your food. Nowadays, cow, pig, chickens are filled with steroids because they sell them by the pound. I went to Church's Chicken the other day, bought a chicken breast, the motherfucker looked like a sofa. Now, if you are filling the animals up with these steroids and the animals are getting bigger, if your kids are eating those animals, what does it do to your kids? It makes your kids bigger. Did you see the titties on that little girl? Did you see the titties on the little girl, Spencer? Okay. This little girl's titties sat up like a goddamn tabletop. You could have set your drink on her titty and not spill a drop. People, I graduated from high school in 1975. In 75, 14-year-old girls ain't had no big-ass titties. In 1975, little girl, 14-year-old girl did not have titties at all. Matter of fact, in 1975, 14-year-old girls was trying to find training bras. Guess what? They don't even sell training bras no more because you're born with titties. It's called that shit they put in the food. So I called R. Kelly at the house. Yeah, we on first name basis. I said, Robert, if you gonna go out with women, there are signs that let you know whether a woman is old enough to date or not. Like, for instance, if they got them little bitty teeth, you can't go out with them. If they wearing a beret, you can't go out with them. If their shoes are lighting up when they walk in, don't do it. If they skipping the whole motherfucking time, please check the ID. But let me tell you what fucked me up. What fucked me up is that documentary came out. And I watched all these grown-ass men who called themselves fathers, who would look right into the camera and said, I went to get my daughter, and they wouldn't let her come out. I don't know where the fuck these country backward summer bitches come from. But I'm from Chicago. Top sack! Projects, Robert Taylor, home 4352 South State, probably 909. I don't know how they do it, where the fuck you come from. But I have a 25-year-old daughter. She means everything to me. She can think she wants some shit and I'll run out and back. She sings like an angel. She's kind to everybody. She loves God. I wish the fuck that I go to R. Kelly's house, fucking Teddy Riley, Superman, any other motherfucker, and they say my daughter's in there, can't come out. I'm going back to catch up with some of my friends at the project. I'm bringing 20 motherfuckers with me with sticks, knives, guns, and pistols. We whooping every ass in that house, and I might fuck somebody. I'm just saying. That's just me.